You see with this DM thing, man, you just don't even
focus. Is it getting ridiculous?
Bro, just don't even look. Don't look.
No. This guy smashed it as Jamie in Top Boy. Now yes. Starring in Ratman's Blue Story, Michael Ward in the building.
Yes.
How are you? You're looking good, bruv.
Thank you, my brother, man.
Coming dripping in the Gucci.
Oh, man, you know, yeah, man, Gucci look after me when I need to. You know what I'm saying?
The past year or two has been a madness.
Insane.
Now, you've probably got so many highlights, but try and tell me what one of the highlights has been for Michael Ward in the last 18 months, 2 years.
How could you expect me to choose
I know
that,
because there's so much to say.
It's a lot, you know.
It's a lot.
Because Top Boy is like the biggest series.
So happy it's
in
back.
The UK.
So happy it's back.
And then we got Blue Story, which is going to be the biggest movie in the UK. So it's like, how do I even pick between the two and the moments as well?
Yeah.
I guess booking the roles are the most important.
Talking about, you know, Blue Story and Ratman, Shiro's story.
Yeah, that was insane. And that's why we're all fans of Ratman's work. So, and that's why you need to see this movie.
For anyone that's not seen Shiro's story, it's like that progressive. It was wicked. It's basically like a little Top Boy, but on YouTube.
Yeah.
It was so, so sick. Now you're this, like, I don't want to say star, but you are kind of, you're a star. You are a bit of a star. Blue tickers are slipping in the DMs now?
Boy.
You're looking tired, Michael.
Boy. You know what? I'm not actually tired. I feel fresh.
Good.
I slept for quite a bit, you know, so I'm good. But you see with this DM thing, man, you just don't even
Is it getting ridiculous?
It, bro, just don't even look. Don't look.
No?
That's what Dave advised me to do. Don't look, man. Just
what Dave? The rapper, yeah?
Yeah, that's bro. Yeah, he said, just don't look.
You might meet the love of your life in there, though. Not yet.
Man. Let me just work. You know what I'm saying? Work.
Yeah.
Put the work in.
Has he given you any more advice?
Who?
Like Dave?
We kind of chop it up a lot of the time, you know what I'm saying? Because he's come from a place where he's come from nothing to something.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? He's expressed that in his psychodrama album and just I've come from nothing to something. So I'm always kind of like, yo, Dave, you got any, you know what I'm saying? Any little gems you can give to me? So he's always dropping a few gems there, here and there. So he's a good guy, man.
Without going too much on Top Boy, was you surprised by Dave's performance in Top Boy?
Yeah, man.
I was hella surprised.
He done really well.
EastEnders Joker.
Yeah, man.
It was sick,
honestly,
man.
Honestly, he done so, so good, man. And he's just going to go on to do even greater things.
Yeah,
he's
big ass safe.
Yeah, man.
But growing up, you didn't actively intend on being an actor, right?
Nah.
So how come you're here now? And what was you going to be if you wasn't an actor?
Bro, like, obviously I was in school and my main passion when I was younger was football, innit? I feel like that's with everyone though, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I hurt my knee.
Like, I feel like, you know what it is, yeah? That's not even what happened to me. I'm going to be honest with you. I just felt like I just wasn't good enough. And when I'm doing something, I want to be the best at it. And I kind of, if I'm not the best, like, I don't know, man, it's just, I don't want it to happen sort of thing. Like, I wasn't really hunting it down.
When did you kind of switch back into acting?
So it wasn't even a switch, bro. I kind of started with modeling first. Like, honestly, it was
same, really.
Yeah, like,
I did petite men.
That's what I was doing at the beginning,
you
too.
You know, junior gap.
Honestly, started with modeling. I won this competition, Face of JD. Like,
yeah.
It used to happen yearly. And then I won it when I was 17. And then it kind of just spiraled from there. I had to make certain decisions because of that.
Yeah.
And them decisions is what allowed me to see acting as a career. So I went to college to do performing arts.
Yeah.
Where I met my agent. And then she just kind of sorted everything out. And then I was with my agency for a year. You know what I'm saying?
Mate!
After that year, we booked Top Boy, man.
You watch Top Boy, obviously, when it first came out.
Of course, I was like
13. It was incredible. So when you landed that role,
yeah,
who was the first person you rang?
My mom.
What'd you say? Mama got a job.
You know what I'm saying? She don't really know the scale of it.
Yeah,
but,
yeah.
You know what I'm trying to say? Like, she understands that it's big enough, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And plus, anything on TV and that.
Anything that mentions Drake.
Yeah, as well. And that was another thing.
Yeah.
Like, when you explain it to her, you got to kind of just say, to people that don't understand, like, yo, yeah, it's Top Boy, but yeah, Drake's behind it. Like,
see,
yeah,
even my nan knows who Drake is.
But then with this as well, it's like Roc Nation are pushing Blue Story and Jay-Z, like these moguls are really getting behind the movie, and that's what's crazy, you know what I'm trying to say? So when I'm breaking down Blue Story to my mum now, I'm like, yeah, like, it's,
this,
you know,
Top Boy's exciting, but this could be on another level because obviously Ratman was chilling with Jay-Z. Do you think that's when the deal was kind of made?
What, you know, what, like, no, this, like, obviously this has nothing to do with them. They're just pushing it out of the natural love for raps and the natural love for the movie. You know what I'm trying to say? They ain't really got nothing to do with this. You know what I'm trying to say? So it's just a natural love. So that's how you know that the movie is special.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm trying to say? These lot don't support stuff that ain't good.
Yeah. Tell me about Blue Story.
Yeah.
Because it's, you know, stems from the Deptford rivalry.
Yeah.
Deptford Peckham. Tell me about growing up as a young black male.
Yeah.
What struggles do you think you had? Do you think you was held back in certain areas? Was you? Do you know what I'm trying
yeah,
to?
Yeah, no, 100%.
Especially when it comes to stuff like acting.
Yeah, yeah.
When
yeah.
it comes to stuff like football.
Like for me, yeah. Like, I just never wanted to ever see it like that. So I kind of used to not put my mindset in that kind of frame.
Yeah, yeah.
I always just used to say, bruv, the opportunities out here. And I'm going to grab them. You know what I'm trying to say? Obviously, a lot of the time, compared to everyone else, we do feel like we have less opportunities and that. But that was before. I feel like now, there's actually so much opportunities being created for everyone to kind of just realize that and step up to the plate and
Big
grab
ups.
Those opportunities, man.
Because you're grabbing bare opportunities. You've been hanging out at the BET Awards in Atlanta.
Bro.
That's a long flight.
Bro.
The thing is, like, because what I like to say the UK is about is, like, I think we can rock a good tracksuit.
Yeah.
Here's being one example. Would you ever rock up to, like, the VETs and, like, a nice trackie? Because I've got a few climacles, you know.
Bro, you know what I'm saying? Bro, I'll rock up in anything. You know what I'm saying? It's not even about that for me. It's the experiences for me. You get what I'm trying to say?
Yeah.
That's what it is. And obviously, when we go somewhere now, people want you to represent their brand. So they're going to allow you to have the space to do that. So
be honest,
that's why I wear.
Do people still call you Jamie on the street?
Yeah, of course,
man. You're walking down, Jamie.
People got that, but that's what's gonna be crazy. I want to see if people are gonna start calling me Marco. or they're just gonna start calling me Michael now because they've seen two different
Mr.
characters.
Like,
you know, could you just call me my name? You get it? But I do understand it because obviously I've done the same thing. Like, so you have to understand. You just gotta be real with yourself. You know what I'm saying? And obviously, the fact that they're calling you that as well, it's like, you've done well. You've done a good job, so people are respecting it. So that's the main thing.
Honestly, Top Boy is my collectively our favourite thing we've seen this year. I can't wait
Thank
to watch
you,
this.
You're going to love this.
Talk to me about Ratman, because he's like a grafter. He's like, I want to say hustler, but he's out there.
He's even had a brand called Put The Work In.
Come on.
From time a man's putting out a brand called Put The Work In, you know what they're about.
You've got
about.
DJ Khaled saying, we the best. And then you got Ratman like this.
Yeah, come on, Put The Work In, because that's all he believes in. You know what I'm trying to say? And to get where you want to be, you have to put the work in, and that's all he does. That's all he does, bro.
What's the best piece of advice Ratman's given you? Because I think, you know, deservedly, he's had this success, especially with Shiro's story.
Course.
What's the best piece of advice he's given Michael Ward? Not the actor, not the model, Michael. What's the best piece of advice he's given to you?
Just kind of just stay focused, man, and believe in myself, you know? Like on set, I had one day where I was kind of just doubting myself, man, and he was just like, brother, like, you really think, man, we'll put this work out there?
Yeah.
If I didn't think it was good. Like, brother, this has got my name on it too, you know? Like, you get what I'm saying? Just believe in yourself. Like,
why don't you do that to me? Like, come on.
Yeah, that's what you're saying, man. So it's just like, yeah, man. Stay focused and just believe in yourself, you know what I'm saying? Because I don't really doubt myself a lot, but, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes it creeps
Sometimes
in.
It just
Yeah, it does,
you,
it
man.
Does. But, you know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, it's just gotta, if you don't believe in yourself, no one else will.
Yeah.
And that's the truth.
But Giggs has been hinting that he knows about some of the stuff that happens. Have you reached out to him to be like, shut up? Or Giggs, just shut up. I know you're talking yardage, but you're talking too much. Do you know what I mean? Jeez. reached out to you about that?
I've obviously spoken to Giggs because I was actually in one of his music videos, his music video with Lily Allen.
Yeah.
I was in there for like 2 seconds, innit? So I was like, to remind him that, like, from there to this, you know what I'm trying to say? And he's obviously, he's seen the film and he respects it. But that's the thing though, when you see something great, it's hard to kind of keep quiet. It's so hard, bro. It's the hardest thing ever. So the fact that he keeps hinting, it's the only way of trying to let something out without letting it out. You know,
like,
one of those,
like,
ones?
I know what goes on.
Yeah.
I know what goes
and that's on. The only way you can really say something without saying something.
Yeah.
Like, and also as well, it just makes people want to go watch the film because he wants people to feel like how he felt.
Yeah.
And same as me. I want people to feel how I felt when I watched the movie because it is special. What Ratman's created is bruv, you're not going to get anything like this.
And this is what's the beauty of the UK, is that we're pushing through this amazing content, and people in America are the thing is, it's always been that situation where I've always, up until the last 5 years, America's always pipped us to the point on some things. Now they're talking about the UK, which is incredible. They're going to be talking about this and everything. Before we let you go, right?
Yeah.
I've been going through your Twitter.
Oh, wow.
Right, now, and I want to go through a few just before you keep going, right?
I want to hear this.
So, these are wicked.
Deep ones. You know,
so Michael Ward tweeted on the 25th of December, 2012, nothing better than Christmas Day EastEnders.
Yeah.
Do you remember that one? When Max got caught cheating.
Was that?
Yeah, that was the one. That was the one. We was all sitting in the front room. Oh, my God. Anyway, got another one.
That's crazy.
Do you know what?
I don't even watch EastEnders anymore. That was my guilty pleasure.
Now, this one makes sense, yeah, because you said you've done it before. You went to, did performing arts.
Mm-hmm.
When you can't watch Glee because the famo's watching some next movie. Was you a big Glee fan?
Big Glee fan, so by the way. Like, honestly, I think, and this is what I say to people as well, Glee, I always say High School Musical, Glee as well, it just showed me I'm allowed to be different. Because you don't see acting as something you can chase, and modelling as well.
Yeah.
Because when I started modelling, a lot of people were like, oh, why are you doing that? Why?
Same.
Bruv, this is what has allowed me to get into what I've done. You know what I'm trying to say? I've seen the other side because of people in Glee. You know what I'm trying to say? It's okay to be different.
Have you seen Kano's live choir?
Suck
your mum, suck your mum. All together. Suck your mum. Michael Ward. Thank you so much for coming in,
brother. Come on. Kiss.